Yo, what is up, everybody, and welcome back to another Madden 22 online CFM game. We are now in week 4 of the 2022 season here in the Premier Madden League. Our Houston Texans have won 2 games in a row, looking to make it 3, but we've got a tough task on our hands with 1, this contract negotiation with Justin Reed. That man wants more money. We'll get him more money if that's what it takes to re-sign him. Don't you worry about that. But we also got a tough task in our hands facing the 3-0 Buffalo Bills. So we want to get 3 wins in a row. We got to be the first team to figure out the Bills in 2021. We've also got to figure out a couple of storylines, including this Nico Collins something. I don't think this is like a dev story or anything, but we can either praise Nico Collins or challenge him, and I'm really not sure which one to pick. I ended up picking challenge Nico Collins, and then I immediately regretted it afterwards. I probably should have just praised the guy and moved on, but I challenged him, and the challenge for Nico Collins is going to end up being that we have to try to get 150 receiving yards with him in our game against the Buffalo Bills, who have a pretty good secondary, and Nico Collins has, I'm not even sure he has 150 yards in the season at this point, so yeah, maybe not the best idea. But back to the contract negotiation stuff, though. We're not going to really even talk to any of our upcoming free agents until we move Deshaun Watson. And let's talk about Deshaun Watson, the elephant in the room every single week. I haven't really talked to you guys too much about the teams we're negotiating with to trade Deshaun Watson to, what we can get back for Deshaun Watson, all of that. It's been a lot behind the scenes going on as far as the fact that there's 31 teams in the league, and I would say a third of the teams in the league asked about Deshaun Watson at some point, maybe even more than that. At least one point asked about Deshaun Watson. Some were more serious than others. And, you know, some teams really pushed forward some, you know, big trade packages to try to get their franchise quarterback. And teams you wouldn't even expect to even be in the race were in the race, right? We had a couple of teams that had superstar X-Factor quarterbacks still ask about Deshaun Watson. We had, you know, multiple teams with young quarterbacks asked about Watson and even talked about trading their young quarterback to us in return. And we even had a team that offered their superstar X-Factor running back in return for Deshaun Watson. But as you guys know, we're not going to do that. Even though there were rumors about how Christian McCaffrey could be traded for Watson, we're not going to do that because I mainly want to get draft picks. I believe that's what the Texans are going to get in return for Watson. And we're going to try to get multiple first round picks. As you guys see, our talent trees, we can't really afford stuff. So that's why I'm not using my points, by the way, just showing you guys some of that. So let's talk about one team that really stepped up to the table to try to trade for Watson. And that's the Detroit Lions and us. We've been working on a trade package that includes 3 first round picks and the left guard Jonah Jackson that they have. He's like a 70 overall, but he's star development. And there was actually a trade that was deep in the works and was almost accepted, but a little hitch in the negotiations between us and the Lions, where the Lions wanted to keep one of their first round picks in 2022, that draft, and then trade us 2 first round picks in 2023, because as you guys know, the Lions also own the Rams first round picks for the next 2 years because of the Stafford trade. It was not something we wanted to do. We're going to get 3 first round picks. I want at least 2 in the upcoming draft because we badly need it. So, and those trade talks ended up falling apart. What's going on right now is this football game between the Houston Texans and the Buffalo Bills. We are underway. Just try to say a lot in a little bit right there, but we are indeed underway with the Houston Texans winning 2 in a row versus the Buffalo Bills, obviously winners of 3 in a row so far, and looking to stay undefeated if they can take care of business today. So yeah, that is part 1 of our Deshaun Watson trade talks. Stay tuned, next episode I might give you guys a lot more details and maybe even an actual trade of where we move Deshaun Watson if we can finalize something. But a deal between us and the Detroit Lions, I think, is off the table. So now we fully focus on today's game. 2nd down and 8, Josh Allen. Wow, that was a dicey throw. We had Gary and Connolly in the flats there, but Connolly doesn't always react to the ball as quickly as others. 3rd down, got the blitz in. Here's Matt Breida underneath, able to stay in bounds, and actually came close to getting the first down. Very close indeed. It's going to be 4th down and inches, though. The Bills on the field from their own 47. Josh Allen out the shotgun, handing off, and Devin Singletary will easily get the first down. And yeah, rushing defense, not exactly our strong suit with this team. We even saw it in the last two losses to the Browns and the Panthers. You know, Nick Chubb and Christian McCaffrey, respectfully, were getting whatever they wanted. They were superstar X-Factors, but it doesn't matter. I feel like anybody can really run on this team, man. When we gave up third down and 13s like that, really, really hurts. We were close, but Stephon Diggs doing Stephon Diggs things out there, and Josh Allen able to fit that ball into tight windows, as you'd expect playing against these Bills. We have a third down and short upcoming after that Matt Breida rush. So let's see if they keep it on the ground, and they will. Breida once again, you see, really just not getting any sort of interior penetration, right? We don't have the manpower to get interior penetration the way you'd really wanted to get a stop on third down short. So that's hurt us two times on this drive so far, and let's see if we could finally get the stop here. Third down and five. This has been an 8 minute opening drive, and it won't be going on for much longer because Josh Allen sails it wide to the left, intended for Emmanuel Sanders, and the Buffalo Bills take 3 points after an over 8 minute opening drive. I would say not a bad deal for us, considering how long, you know, the shenanigans were going on, man, to hold them to three instead of seven. We'll take that, and we'll just try to focus on the offensive end as Davis Mills is spilled down to the ground. That's going to be the defensive tackle, Ed Oliver. And not a great way to start our first offensive series. Now we're facing a third down and 15. Davis Mills dropping back. Three-man rush will give him the time. But is anyone open in the corner? That's Nico Collins. And as you guys may know, Nico Collins is looking for 150 receiving yards. If we get that, I don't know what happens. Maybe he gets a dev story. I have no idea, but it would be in our best interest to try to get those 150 yards. But, you know, first things first, we have to try to get 150 passing yards, period, against these Bills. And we did not do a good job on that opening series. We end up punting the ball as Stephon Diggs makes the reception there. Start the second quarter, Matt Breida running the ball. The Bills are actually one of the better rushing attacks so far in this early 2021 campaign. And you can see why. Yeah, Stephon Diggs. Oh, he's got it for the touchdown. Diggs mossing Justin Reed, who is looking for a new contract, but not exactly playing like he deserves the high salary that he's asking for. Because, I mean, man, he's our best defensive back, but at the same time, Justin Reed's not even close to a 99 overall. He's not the Minka Fitzpatrick of our Miami Dolphins. He is, what, an 83 overall? He's not, you know, exactly too much of a beast out there, but still, he's our best defender. If anybody's going to make a play in that situation, I expect it to be him as we went for the swat there, but Stephon Diggs doing Stephon Diggs things, I suppose. Davis Mills, he's got him. It's Brandon Cooks, and Cooks is in for the touchdown. A quick response by the Houston Texans, and Brandon Cooks, I thought he was going to shoot the bow and arrow right there, but he just gets on his knees and celebrates, and what little stretch we have with Brandon Cooks here. After that big game on Thursday Night Football, it seems like putting Brandon Cooks outside and just putting him on streaks is our best offense. At some point, teams are going to adjust to that, right? And just very easily adjust to that and just put a safety over the top of Brandon Cooks and probably just cover everyone else on our team pretty well, since we are pretty easy to cover. But, I mean, for now, it's working, so we got to keep on going to it. We get a stop here. It's third down in inches. Can we get the stop on third and short? Not even close. Zach Moss on the run, getting away. Sanders throwing a couple of good blocks outside, and that's going to be a 30-yard rush. We needed to hold him to zero, and we gave up 30 instead. I think that says all you need to know about this squad. Is the Bills going to a lot of curl routes early on. Stephon Diggs one more time on the reception. And clearly, we got to do a better job of guarding Diggs. There he is again, and I don't think we did a good job of guarding Stephon Diggs. We had our rookie linebacker, like a 63 overall on him, but it worked. We got the incompletion, but it doesn't really matter because very next play, that's Matt Breida on the reception. Josh Allen dropping back, and Allen able to run away. It's bad enough that we're not really getting much of a pass rush. And Josh Allen, whenever we even do get a sniff, he can get away that easily. Yeah, it's going to be a long day for this Texans defense as Stephon Diggs already with his second touchdown reception of the game. And this is a little bit of a reality check for our Houston Texans, right? We've been loving life the past couple of weeks, but now that we play against one of the top teams in the AFC, we kind of get a sniff of what true competition is all about. We played the 0-2 Panthers, and, you know, like I said in that video, they kind of played like the 0-2 Panthers. And the Browns, they are currently 0-3, so, you know, they kind of, once again, are living up to their reputation. Meanwhile, you know, we played against the Jaguars week one. They haven't lost yet. We're playing against the Bills. They haven't lost yet either. It's third down and nine. Davis Mills backing way up. Nothing there. And we're going to have to just take the sack right there. A straight-up coverage sack. And You know, rushing three, eventually our line's going to give up something. We can't expect to be in there forever, so we just have to punt the ball right there. And, you know, it's just not much materializing. Not much Nico Collins. Brandon Cooks is running a streak. I'm not sure what our answer is. Meanwhile, for the Buffalo Bills, they got everything open on that left side. Definitely needs a better coverage on that end. And quickly, we have a red zone possession already with a 10-point lead out the two-minute warning. The Bills looking for more. Josh Allen dropping back. Going end zone! Sketchy, but thankfully swatted away by Bradley Roby, who's easily been our best defensive back so far this season, at least our best cornerback. As third down and 10, Emmanuel Sanders able to get by Grugier Hill, I believe is how you pronounce that one. Get the first down. Next play, no huddle. It's Josh Allen, the big Buffalo himself, untouched. He's got it for six, and man, oh man, are we in trouble looking at that play right there, because Josh Allen on the QB wrap. No one even tried to lay a finger on that man. Like, we were allergic to him. So, 24 points given up in the first half, and it could have even been worse. Looking at it, as Davis Mills pump faking, throwing the ball here with 46 seconds left. And our offense, meanwhile, besides one deep throw to Brandon Cooks, has been completely stymized here. So, we're not in Kansas anymore, I suppose. We're not in Carolina anymore, as we have Davis Mills running outside and just getting out of bounds there. We still have two timeouts here, so let's see if we can get something going before the end of the first half. Mills underneath. He's going to find Brandon Cooks, but that's going to be inbounds. So, yeah, we're going to call our second timeout here with 31 seconds left. Third down and five at the 40-yard line, and we're dropping back with Mills out the spread. Outside, that's Nico Collins. I believe that's going to be the first reception for him, and a little bit of unnecessary roughness and an unnecessary bad pass by Davis Mills intended for Brandon Cooks. Second down, Mills outside. Got Brevin Jordan. Haven't really called his name either. The rookie tight end coming off an explosive game. Need a little bit more from him. Third down and seven, though. We're actually going to go underneath to David Johnson. And David Johnson, unfortunately, cannot get out of bounds. So that's our final timeout. This is not really field goal range for Kyamie Fairbairn. So we're going to have to get a quick hitter out of bounds with 10 seconds left. Mills, good pocket outside. Oh, he's just going to get it in to Brevin Jordan, who's starting to awaken. And that's good enough for us to get in the field goal range. We're not going to run their offensive play and even chance anything. And we get a field goal, which I feel like we had to work so hard to even just get a field goal on that drive, man. Life of the Houston Texans, if we just squib it. Final play of the first half is looking sketchy. Matt Breida getting the edge. What is going on here? Come on, boys, just get to halftime, please. And thank you. Let's go to the halftime show and catch our breath. Welcome to the Halftime Show, where today's Game of the Week features the undefeated Las Vegas Raiders invading the home of the rival LA Chargers. Oh man, Henry Ruggs is off to an electric start this season, but who's guarding Keenan Allen? A bust in the coverage, and Allen's in 4-6. The first half of this one was all LA. On the move, it's Austin Ekeler. Whoa, hit the brakes and accelerate. That was definitely some nice stick work, but right back at you, it's the aerial assault of the Las Vegas Raiders. A go-ahead touchdown to Hunter Renfro. Next drive, a major undercut by Casey Hayward, and the Raiders have absolutely flipped the script. But the Chargers are looking to make one last push. Fourth down and goal. Open man. Keenan Allen once again in the end zone. Looking to get a stop on Derek Carr. And the Raiders, who won it all, they gamble and win big. It's Ruggs. Put this one on ice. Keep the undefeated season alive. Let's go to the rest of the action, starting off with Tony Pollard just maneuvering his way through that great wall of Dallas, looking to keep the Panthers winless so far this season. And well, the Panthers are doing a pretty good job of that themselves. Cam Newton missing the open man, Anthony Brown. Yeah, that's an easy victory for the Dallas Cowboys. Moving on in the rain, check out Mick Nichols on the move, skating. And it looks like the Jets forgot their skates. Oh, baby, what a play. Then Tannehill downfield. Yeah, that'll do it in this one. A.J. Brown just mossed the man. Titans move to 3-1. Jets losing their last two after starting 2-0. How about Tom Brady's return to New England? This was one of the games circled on the calendar for everybody in 2021, but the Patriots have come to play. But who's going to get the last laugh? It's got to be Tom Brady, and it's got to be in the clutch. Tom was always going to win this game. The Buccaneers get the dub. They go to 2-2. Brady almost 300 yards passing. Aaron Rodgers losing the ball, but that was just a blip in the radar because A-Rod had quite the game, and Davante Adams, that's one of his three touchdowns on the day. The Packers stay undefeated. Meanwhile, Steelers really struggling. Speaking of struggle town, man, Russell Wilson had a rough outing in Santa Clara. Not one, not two, not three. Keep it counting. Yeah, six interceptions, and that might have been the worst of them all. Jaquiski Tarr on the run back as well. This was an ugly game as far as offenses go. The 49ers defense at the end of the day pulls out that win in the NFC West, as that's Kadarius Toney, the rookie out of Florida. He's got the burners. He's got the touchdown. The Giants got the victory. Here's Jonathan Taylor on the move. Colts already up in this one. Taylor just looking to add to his highlight reel. Check and check. Colts, the sweaty Colts guy, formerly the sweaty Bears guy, now 4-0. Oh no, that's gonna hurt. This is Mike Hughes. He'll run this one back. The Chiefs get a pretty easy victory in Philly. Moving on, how about Jared Goff on a new team? Washington just traded to the Washington football team. He had quite a day, but that play really hurt and ultimately resulted in a Falcons victory. The surprising Falcons 3-1 to start the season. So, who is that quarterback for the Detroit Lions now that Goff is out of town? Trace McSorley leading the Lions to their second straight victory. And finally, a defensive battle ultimately won by the Jacksonville Jaguars. They will stay undefeated. Lawrence almost 300 yards. And we are back for the start of the second half. And you know what, guys? We are in a pretty decent situation here. It was looking bleak, but we are down by two possessions with the ball to start the second half. Dare I say it? We can win this game. We'll have to make opportunistic plays, but we can definitely win this game. It starts with this drive, though. Third down and five, Davis Mills. Well, that's why we can't win the game. If we're going to lose it, it's going to be plays like that where we have an open man on third down. David Johnson out the backfield, and Mills just sails it as the Bills are going to start off pitching to Matt Breida. You see the Bills, you know, they've been running the ball decently this game. They haven't broken off that big run yet, but it seems like they're consistently getting 4 to 5 yards every single carry as we stop them, as I say that. And there's an injury to one of their offensive linemen. But, yeah, it feels like, you know, the Bills are at least getting that, and that's partially because we have to respect their passing game so much. So the balance of the Buffalo Bills right now seems to really be hurting us. But we might be strapping up a little bit in the second half, kind of like what we did with Nick Chubb. As I say that, though, Matt Breida, yeah, maybe we are really going to struggle. Breida, if he's running like that one more time. Matt Breida gets away from Nicholson. Down goes Reed. In goes Breida. And the Buffalo Bills, they definitely felt a little bit nervous coming out of halftime, but I think they'll feel a lot better after that sequence of events. And, you know, that's, you know, reality set in there. I was being very opportunistic when I, not just a little opportunistic, very, when I was saying we had a chance to win the game. And we had to play almost perfect. And like I said, we had to really make big plays out there. But now Davis Mills in a pickle, in a jam. That's an absolute jam for Brandon Cooks to try to find the football in. That'll be intercepted by Jordan Poyer. And yeah, those kind of plays were eventually going to happen to us. Just a lot of pressure on our offense to play well. And like I said, even when we play well, Davis Mills is still going to miss open passes sometimes. It feels like he misses a wide open third down at least once a game. So that's pretty much punting a possession once a game, as Josh Allen. Whoa, Neville Hewitt made him pay the price, and he doesn't even get the first down for taking that monster shot as the Bills line up to punt the ball here. That's the closest thing we've come to getting a stop for our defense. We had the first drive where they missed a guy open, Emmanuel Sanders, and there, where Josh Allen was a yard short. So, I mean, hey, we'll take stops any way we can get them as we are winding down the third quarter here. Offensive line picks up the pressure pretty well, and we find that man, Nico Collins, one more time. I don't think Nico Collins is getting 150 yards. Like I said, we barely have 150 yards as a team passing the ball, as Davis Mills taking off, getting a gain of 9 as we run the ball here with Philip Lindsay. Not something we've done much since we've been down most of the game, but Lindsay wants the football to make plays like this. Philip Lindsay all the way to the 3-yard line. We'll hand it off to David Johnson. Spill Lindsay for a play. See if Johnson can bruise his way in. He gets us to the 1-yard line. Now Phillip's back in. And Phillip is tripped up, even losing a yard. Now it's third down and goal, and we're in a shotgun spread, looking for an RPO there, and that's a good drop there by Brevin Jordan, I suppose. So it's going to be fourth down and goal at the two. Got to go for it here with under a minute to go in the third quarter. We are in the Wildcat. It's Lindsey, and he's going to snap the ball to David Johnson. Great block outside, and David Johnson's got the touchdown. It's technically going to count as a touchdown pass by Philip Lindsey, but hey, man, any way we can score a touchdown, we will take it. As we showed last week, you know, sometimes it takes some very unique plays to try to get touchdowns. Like, we got a Tim Tebow touchdown last week. I haven't seen Tebow yet so far in this game. As Matt Breida, that's the man we'll really have to stop if we want to win this game, as Breida's over 100 yards rushing. Going to get a lot more there. Once again, missed tackles all over the field, that time by Zach Cunningham, and missed tackles by some of our better players on the team. There you go, another missed tackle. That's Justin Reed not able to blow up Matt Breida. Underneath, that's going to be Cole Beasley on the RPO, and the Bills doing a good job of milking clock and really trying to get into that field goal range to try to make this a three-possession game. Josh Allen, though, wants the touchdown, but maybe a bit too ambitious, going cross-body there. This Stephon Diggs missing the mark, second down. Allen all the time in the world, but now he's in trouble, and he's still going to force it in the corner, and that's going to be a pick. They will count that as an interception? Yeah. How about Desmond King making the play, and Josh Allen just a little ignorant there, just refused to throw the ball away. Really wanted to make a play. I guess that's Josh Allen football, as David Johnson dropping the pass there. That's going to bring up a third down and three. And once again, that's where I say that, you know, you need all the cogs in the machine working together. And, you know, you got one cog loose, that's an issue. You got four or five cogs loose at the same time, you're the Houston Texans. And as I say that, there's the offensive line. Hello. Try to take a deep shot there. Try to, you know, put a bunch of routes downfield, and we don't really have the manpower for that. Bills play good defense. We don't have the offensive line to hold up for those kind of plays. Now we're here at a third down and 21 with under 6 minutes to go in regulation. Really need this drive. We've given ourselves a chance with that Desmond King interception, but to have ourselves a chance, we got to convert this fourth down and 14 with the clock moving. Mills out the empty set, only a three-man rush by the Buffalo Bills. Here's the pressure, and it's going to force a bad pass by Mills and a turnover on downs. And once again, Davis Mills on a key down and distance, just missing the mark. And you know, that throw right there probably would have been a first down, because we were going to throw over the head of the defensive tackle Ed Oliver, who dropped into coverage, and we was Antonio Callaway, our intended receiver. And yeah, Davis Mills just doing Davis Mills things out there. And, you know, we've absolutely handicapped ourselves, and it's definitely showing in this game. The handicap is definitely playing a factor, as the Bills are in range to at least kick a field goal, but they're without Stephon Diggs for the rest of the game, as Josh Allen getting away from the pressure one more time, turns it upfield, and Josh Allen, he's in for an 18-yard rushing touchdown. Well, that's not even close to telling the story. Josh Allen, talk about superstar players making superstar plays on the field. That's exactly what Josh Allen did right there. And as I was talking about the handicap holding us back, I think that's a pretty good exhibit A right there, right? Had Josh Allen in our grasp, and you know, 94 is just not quick enough to keep up with Josh Allen. He's not athletic enough, and no one on our team was seemed like right there. So, yeah, it's, you know, like I said, it's what we signed up for. I said it in the first episode. We signed up for a very tough task, because not only do we have the Houston Texans, we've been put in the toughest division in the league. Not only did we get put in the toughest division in the league, we've been put in the toughest conference in the league. Not only did we get put in the toughest conference in the league, we are in the same league where some of the better users in the league have been given teams like the Chiefs, and as you see here, the Bills. So, and even like the Chargers and stuff like that, pretty decent teams. Meanwhile, we are here with the Houston Texans trying to make the playoffs and maybe trying to make a Super Bowl push, right? It's going to be very, very difficult, especially this season and even next season, as Davis Mills on the run looking for Nico. Aha, Davis Mills, miss one more pass, please, I dare you. Come on, man. Third down and 15. We dump it underneath to Brandon Cooks here. We're at the two-minute warning. Down by 21. Winning the game is not really much of a possibility anymore. We're just trying to keep it as close as possible. Keep it respectful, I suppose. Fourth down and five. We're not going to kick the field goal here. Going to go for it. Keep the offense in the field. Push for touchdowns. And push for touchdowns on this very play. But that's going to be swatted and actually intercepted right there. It looked like the Bills tried to just play for the swat. But Micah Hyde, he's going to play for the stats. And it's actually going to work out for Micah Hyde very well, because there he goes. He gets away from Mills in the pack, and Micah Hyde, almost a 100-yard pick six. Kick a man while he's down, why don't you, Micah? Sheesh. I was a little bit on meat. Okay, I pass led that one inside into the defensive back. If I just let it straight in the middle, I mean, we might have had a chance to give it to Brandon Cooks, but I just didn't trust the arm of Davis Mills, because if we had a stronger arm quarterback, we could make that throw as well. That's also going to be picked off by Nickerson, and Nickerson off to the races. Is he going to get a pick six as well? Mills will prevent that from happening, and the Bills are just going to kneel this one out. That's going to be ball game, and finally we can mercifully end this game that it looked like we might have had a chance in a couple of times, right? We were down by 14 with the ball twice in this game, and we just were not able to come up with the drives, but that's the thing. We have to play almost perfect football to win some of these games, and when you don't play perfect with the Houston Texans, this is what the result's going to be. Now, it ended up being a little bit worse because we threw a pick six at the end, but, you know, this is what the game's going to look like. And, you know, like I said, man, I'm cool with it. I'm absolutely cool with it. If you guys are cool with the challenge of the potential struggle, then strap in, because we're going to have some fun with this series. And when we turn it around, man, it's going to be that much better, I suppose. But, yeah, like I said, man, the league's in a weird spot where, like, we are you know, in a major handicap for some reason. I don't even feel like I'm, like, the best player in the league or anything like that. But, you know, we signed up for it, and we'll just have to deal with it. Unfortunately, Nico Collins did not get close to his 150 yards. I'm not sure what would have happened if we got it, but we're about to find out what happens when you don't get the 150 yards. And once again, this is why I really wish I would have just praised the guy and said, no, you're okay. You don't have to be Brandon Cooks in this offense. I really should have just told him the truth instead of just being like, hey, Nico, yeah, you can be Brandon Cooks, too. I'm an idiot for that. But I also don't know what the QB1 check-in's all about. They wanted us to win the game against the Buffalo Bills, and we didn't do that. So I'm a little worried about the morale of our team, what it's going to be like. We are 2-2, which is not too bad, right? Like, in the grand scheme of things, 2-2 with the Houston Texans is not the worst thing in the world. But these scenarios that just so happened to pop up and won the games we lost might not do us too well. So week 5, we have the New England Patriots. We'll look to bounce back there, maybe get a Deshaun Watson trade done. I'm not quite sure. A small injury note in this game that I didn't realize happened until afterwards. We signed James Carpenter to be a starting offensive lineman for us out of free agency, and he got injured, and he's going to be out for the next month. So it seems like every single game we play, someone gets injured, and they're out for a month. So that's cool as well. But yeah, I'll catch you guys next time. Thank you guys, as always, for watching and supporting our Houston Texans through the best of times and the worst of times.